What you're looking at here is BetAngel trading multiple tennis matches at exactly the same time. We can see we've got Guardian open here. We don't have to have this open, but we have it open for demonstration purposes. The watch list over here with the matches that we're trading along with the scores. And then the main focus of BetAngel over here. If we want to look at any one of these matches, we can skip backwards and forwards from here. But the clever thing about what we're doing here is BetAngel can do this in the background while we're trading another sport. So we could be trading a specific tennis match using one interface or another. Or you could actually be doing horse racing or something else while it trades all of these matches in the background. If you're interested in learning how to do this, then watch the rest of this video. If you want instant access to new videos as they're uploaded, then please click on the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to comment on the videos. And if you're interested in learning more about BetAngel, visit betangel.com today and download a free trial. So let us have a look at how the rule to back the current server was constructed. What's the detail that goes behind that? If I go to the automation tab, I can select from the drop-down menu the trade to the server rule, and we can have a look by editing the rules file, and I can explain to you how this rule was constructed. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to obviously back the server within the market, and obviously that goes without saying. That's what we're trying to do, is we're trying to profit from the fact that when the server serves, they've got a good chance of closing out the game and their odds will shorten. So we've named the first rule within this container, back the server, player one. We place a back bet. We do it relative to the in-play time. So we're saying when the match goes in play, we can start executing this rule. And we will do that for up to 23 hours or whatever period you nominate after the event goes in play. Now, what we've done here is we've said we will allow the trigger to roll 99 times. These are arbitrary figures. All the things on here are arbitrary. It's up to you how you want to list these rules. You don't have to use the same rules as I, and you may want to experiment and mess around. And I'm also not saying that these rules are profitable. I'm just giving you an example of the mechanics of how to create a rule. So all these numbers can be changed. But basically, the reason we're asking for more than one trigger is we're saying that we want the opportunity to back the server more than once within this particular game. And we're saying wait 60 seconds before doing it again. You'll understand why as we talk ourselves through this rule. It applies to selection one, so we're saying player one, the guy at the top of the list on the Betfair order. Now you could actually nominate this to a player, but we don't recommend that because it will only execute on that particular named player in the future. So that's why we've selected in row one. You can see there we can do it by name, row, or order of favoritism. So you could create this rule around backing the favorite if you wanted to, but we've chosen to do it as the first line on the Betfair row. And by first line, what we mean here is it would be Kuznetsova, this person, this person, this person, and this person. Whereas if we nominated row two, it'd be Wozniacki and then the other players within this particular list. So that's what we've done there. The parameters we're using is we're going to back at the best market price for a fixed amount. Simple as that. We're going to back whatever price is available for £2. Now obviously you could vary that according to however you wanted to do it, but that's entirely up to you how you wish to do that. But the most important part here are the conditions. So we are going to place a back bet in this market subject to the following conditions. So when you look at conditions, you have to use a bit of sense and logic. So what we're doing here is we're saying this condition is met, and this condition, and that condition, and this condition. So it has to meet all four of these conditions in order to place a back bet. So the first condition, which is quite important in tennis, is the tennis serving condition. So we're saying here, the selection is serving. So we're saying player that's listed here, player one, is serving. So you could say player one is serving or not serving. So either serving or receiving, effectively, is what we're saying here. What we're also doing here is we're saying that this can occur in any set, in any game, but it can only occur when the player is 15 love up. Now, the reason that we've chosen 15 love is we could actually have chosen love all, but the problem with that is perhaps there's a break in the game or there's a rain delay. So we want some evidence that the game is actually underway if we're going to have this running in the background. So that's why we've chosen 15 love. We're saying player one is serving and they're 15 love up, and that is what will initiate the trade into the market. That's how it's going to work. What we've also done here is we've said the number of unmatched bets within the market is equal to zero. So this is stopping us from doubling up on our position. So say it backs once. When it goes to try again, it will make sure that that back bet has been matched, or that the trade out value has been matched. We're basically saying we only want one position in the market at any one particular moment in time. We don't want to have more than one at any one particular moment in time. So that's a condition that we've added to the mix here as well. And then the final rule that we've added at the bottom here is we've basically said matched bets amounts condition. So this is basically saying that the number of back bets in the market is equal to the number of lay bets in the market. Why have we done that? What is the situation that is going to create the conditions for this? Well, basically what we're saying is we want to trade in and trade out, and then we can put a new bet in the market. So if we've just traded in once and we have not traded out, then we obviously don't want to put another one in the market. So alongside the unmatched bets condition, this is an error trapping rule that says no more than one bet in the market at any one particular moment in time. So we're basically saying back the player one if they're serving, if the score is 15 love, and there are no unmatched bets in the market and no stray amounts hanging around all over the place. So that's the first part of the rule that we've put in here with inside this container. Now we obviously need to close the position as well. So we're backing the player when they first step up to serve, or actually in this case when they're 15 love up. And at the end of the game, we want to hedge that position out. We want to close that trade for whatever profit or loss we've made at that particular moment in time. So you can see here what we've actually created within the general area is we've named it close position at the end of the game, so we know exactly what this rule is supposed to be doing. And we've selected the rule type close trade on selection. We've said relative to the in play time again at the start of the match going on for 23 hours, and do this quite a few times. No parameters are required here, but there are conditions required. So we're basically, if you think about this logically, what we're saying is that player A is now not serving. So that must mean that that game has finished and we've moved on to the next game. And to qualify that, we've also said that the points within the match is love all. So we're saying player one is not serving and it's love all. And at that point, we will close our position. So we're backing at 15 love and we're closing at love all when the other player is serving. So can you see how we've created the opening trade at the beginning of a game and we've closed it when the serve switches play? What we've also put up here as well is you can see here cancel stray bets if player one is behind. Cancel stray bets if player one is ahead. So let's say this is another bit of error trapping. You could actually leave it there with the first two rules within this container, but the two conditions that we've got here are basically mopping up if there's a problem somewhere. So if we look at exactly what we've done here, we've basically said cancel all unmatched bets in the market during this in-play period. And the conditions, no parameters of course, because it's just issuing a command to cancel all bets. And the conditions are if the relative score is that the player is one or more points behind, then it will basically cancel out any bets. So say we put one bet in, put another one in, and it doesn't match for one reason or another. Rather than doubling, trebling up positions, we're basically just cancelling out any loose bets that are available within the market. And what we've done is we've done that if player one is behind or player one is ahead. We've just basically copied the rule and changed the conditions. So that's another bit of a safety net, but again, it's up to you whether you want to use these or not. But what I'm trying to get across here is the core strategy of backing at 15 love and trading at the end of the game is very simple, and we've added in a few conditions as well in order to make sure that bets go into the market at particular moments in time. More important are the conditions that we've applied on the first and second rule, and the other bits and bobs that we've put in there are sort of nice to haves as well. Especially in terms of unmatched bets and stray bets that are in the market. You may want to consider that. But at its core, the first two rules that you see within this particular container are very simple, and they use the new functionality that we've got around live scores within the automation to achieve what we want. And you can vary this by any particular case. So you could do up a game, down a game, up a set, down a set, serving an upper set in the second set, or love 30. There are so many variations, impossible to show you all of them, but hopefully that's given you a hint at some of the power that you can have with the new automation and the ability to use live scores within the automation as well.
If you're interested in learning more about BetAngel, visit betangel.com and download a free trial today.